Good afternoon, dear colleagues. I am very thankful to organizer, my favorite ones, for invitation. With a great pleasure, I've come once again to my favorite city, lymphomas. It's not a rare disease. Every oncologist may see it, and hematologists, lymphomas plays a very important place in our practice. So there may be Hodgkin's, non-Hodgkin's lymphomas, you know, classification. As to Hodgkin's lymphomas, there are clinical risk factors depending on different groups. For example, the European group of oncology, together with Italian, Korean, and German groups, they have different prognostic factors. But first of all, it's elevation of erythrocyte sedimentation rate more than 50 millimeters per hour. There may be the difference in groups of the involved lymph nodes. The European group says that age does important if a person older than 50 years of age. Korean group, they say older than 40 years. The German group, they place in the first place extranodal advancement and the involvement of more than two lymphatic regional zones. Korean group, more than three lymph nodes are involved. Well, it does influence the choice of our field, irradiation field, and dose. Radiation therapy has always been in the core of the treatment of lymphomas. But how the approach has changed? The slide shows classical fields. If the tumors were in the upper mediastinum or in the neck, the whole upper part of the body, including axillary regions, were irradiated. If lymphomas, they were located in the abdomen, the spleen is involved in radiation as well. If in the small pelvis or large pelvis, it's well known inverted Y letter. In this pattern, irradiation was made. What else has changed? The standardized dose was not less than 36 gray and not more than 40 grays. It's a Hodgkin's lymphoma that is sensitive to the radiation therapy. 2D applied and later 3D planning started to be used. Undoubtedly, applying these doses, if there is involvement of the mediastinum, practically the similar dose was applied to the pericardium and the main vessels. The lungs received quite substantial integral dose. What else is important? If patients are females, breasts, they receive the integral dose as well. We are talking about the fact how well we treat the patients, but what happens in 10 years? What happened in 10 years? Hodgkin's lymphomas, mostly, these are the patients of young age. Of course, cardiopathy, fibrotic changes in the lungs, and secondary sarcomas of the breasts. Let's consider different aspects. Here I the role of the PET and subgroups of Hodgkin's lymphomas. They may benefit.
So Here, what concerns the results of treatment at early age and stage, that is 1A and 1B. They compared several groups, which together with chemotherapy changed the dose. There were one group with 30 gray after four courses, and the second group was given 20 gray. What was the difference? No difference in the response. Tumors at early and favorable prognosis in Hodgkin's lymphoma responded almost in 100%, the same way as 30 gray and 20 gray. After that, it changed approach to treatment of lymphoma. If previously we were radiating lymph regions, after PET we started to identify those groups of lymph nodes that accumulated metabolic activity of tumor cells. Here we see the results of treatment of Hodgkin's lymphoma. There are two groups. In one patient received solely chemotherapy, and the second received chemo radiotherapy. This slide shows that secondary tumor in patients who received additional radiotherapy was 11.4%, and mortality was 11.8% in additional radiotherapy versus 6.1%. And we are talking about early stages of Hodgkin's lymphoma. What happened? Analyzing the results, the group came to the conclusion that there are groups when it's not necessary to give additional radiotherapy, and it is based on using this PET and PET after certain courses. These are famous fields in 1970s when irradiated large fields. This is the picture. Starting from 1995, they introduced the definition of FRT, that is involved field. Since 1998, we check the involvement of lymph nodes. On this slide, you can look at irradiating. That slide compares two groups with favorable prognosis and risk factors. And depending on that, we identify the groups who can receive radiotherapy and those which are not recommended. And here we can talk about 1A stage, when, and there were trials which show that after two courses of ABVD, they made PET, if PET showed elimination of metabolic activity of tumor cells, they continued chemotherapy for courses and then discontinued. And that group benefits. Here we help to avoid toxicity for this group that can be a burden for cardiovascular system. But that group which has first B, second B stages, we know that at fourth stage, patients with lymphoma go to other specialists. But we are talking about the groups who have unfavorable prognostic factors. Radiotherapy remains the basic method after chemotherapy. Where are the changes in selection of the technique of radiotherapy? This upper slide shows a 3D picture in the lower MRT. We cannot get rid of integral dose on the lung. Still, we have fields that overlap our target, but we can relieve the burden on the spinal cord the same way on pericardium. Here in 3D, these fields meet. Even if it's 20 degrees, still all organs receive the full dose. Of course, it's difficult to make a boundary between the breast. We cannot go away from this risk. Can we use radiotherapy as independent method of treatment? Yes, of course. But in case chemotherapy is not available due to some reasons, there are some indications, toxicity or intolerability or age, there can be different factors. In this case, now we are talking about non-Hodgkin's lymphoma. In this case, what are we basing ourselves on? It's PET. It's fundamental. If one cannot use PET, there has to be a computer with contrast matter, or we have to compare with previous images before starting chemotherapy. And of course, we have to look. GTV must have good imaging and GTV, and we have to include adjacent lymph nodes, groin region in this particular case. There can be the choice of the dose depends on the tumor characteristics in this case. Depending on the type, when we talk about independent use of radiotherapy, the distribution of dose can be from 35 to 55 degrees, depending on aggressiveness. In follicular lymphomas, we can have 45 gray, and lymphoma of marginal zone, we can give 30 gray. 20 years ago, this dose was 50 gray. If we use chemotherapy in different types of lymphomas, it's important to make PET before and after chemotherapy. And we radiate only that zones which accumulates contrast matter showing activity of the tumor. After chemotherapy, if we use consolidation radiotherapy after chemotherapy, follicular lymphoma, we see the dose is only 24 gray. In diffuse B cell aggressive lymphoma, consolidation radiotherapy after chemotherapy has only 30 gray. Such localization of extranodal lymphoma we see primary intraocular lymphoma, and we include optic nerve, chiasma into the fields. Radiotherapy can be used in an independent method. The dose has to be 36 gray. Such localization of lymphoma, such as central nervous system, which is quite common. In this case, after chemotherapy consolidation dose is 24 gray. After total response, we maintain high dose 36-45 gray. And total radiation in a dependent mode implies quite high doses. 45-55 gray. What refers to T cell lymphoma of nasal type? Lymphoma is aggressive. We use chemotherapy as well, joint treatment. So we can see the whole region with the advancement of tumor. Usually we give more than 50 gray, reaching 65 gray. As to non-Hodgkin extranodal lymphomas, say mesenterial lymphoma, after chemotherapy, if there is full response, so the dose is not large, it's only 30 gray. As to lymphoma of gastric lymphoma, like MALT, I like it. It responds to chemo radiotherapy well. I have a lot of patients who received radiotherapy, and even in an independent mode of 30 gray, when we give practically 98% of patients have full regression of tumor. In conclusion, if there is a chance, please use PET. It's not a problem, even in Russia. Regions have PET. Don't forget to decrease the volume of radiation fields. You have to look at the involved lymph nodes, and we have to adapt the dose, even if we need to reprogram during radiotherapy. Thank you. Thank you very much. We have time for a couple of questions. Very interesting. Thank you very much. Yes, we conduct chemoradiotherapy in Hodgkin's lymphoma. We often have gastric cancer. What about, and how do you, well, what about pre-radium preparation, empty stomach? We recommend not to drink 2 hours before radiotherapy, not to eat 3 or 4 hours before the start of radiotherapy. And each session has to, well, meet the same conditions. Gating, no, of course. Which gastric lymphoma? MALT lymphoma. Thank you. I had patients who had tumor in duodenum. It's impossible to see it. And we don't use dose higher than 30 gray. And if you see the tumor, usually we use CT with enhancement. We take DTV. If you take 0.5 from DTV to PTV, it's 1.5 centimeters.